boyfriend and girlfriend, don't look at me like that. Because that kind of fiancé, fiancé, boy is boyfriend and girlfriend. And there is no man under this earth who has ever been a boyfriend or girlfriend before marrying. Even if it is one day that you propose to the person, and at the following week, and our wedding now, 1 week, we are boyfriend and girlfriend. A crippled man lying there. This man has something great in him. He just needs somebody to quicken that him for him to rise up. Let me tell you something. The power for the man to walk is in him already. The man just needs somebody to spark that power. There are times when you are driving and your battery for you jump it. To kick it. So the man just needs a battery that is more powerful than his to kick his for him to rise. But there was nobody to do that. And he was lying at the beautiful gate. There are some of us that is what they are, how they have made us. Your father is rich. Your mother is rich. Your uncles are rich. They send you to school. School, I want you to go here. 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 I want There are most times I use myself as an example. Some years back, someone said she wanted to send me to school. I said, you wanted to send me to school? She said, yes. I said, okay. For you, you are a pensioner. You are pension paid. And soon is school. You know something? This is a developing place. Who's you got you loan, eh? This is a developing place. I have a certificate. SHS certificate. I can go to university at any time I want to go. Go and take a loan. Who get? Memfa family. Pepa. I have seen this business. Because this place is a developing place, this business will boom. So give me that money. Let me do the business. Give me 6 months or 1 year. I'll pay you your money. She refused. Because I still go to school. And I was going to go in that time. That is African mentality. The BFL grew in your papa. Say, Papa, you knew your papa. Apostles, apostles, and locals. You don't need them in Ghana. Yes, but we need a Chinese one and the Indian Mahindra. Those are the ones who want to drive. Anything that is coming from Africa, Papa, when you pay you on the Niasio, Papa, when you peace and Niasi, yes, be peace and Niasi, yes, who will pay you? Who pay you now? Who will know? And you pay you tutu, and you pay you cocoa, and you pay you every Padam, and you pay you Esayatia, and you pay you Sita, and you pay you Episro, and you pay you every two people. Yes, you will pay you. Pay you now, you want to. Pay you, pay you. Let me add you back. Yeah! Let me pay you now, you want. Yes, you will pay you. Pay you, you will be back. Me tell the reason why you will pay you. The reason why you will pay you, he said. Nyangupo. Onu mo bo obunsa. Eno di ni huhu. Emo obunsa. Eno obunsa. Edi ja nyankopo. Eno obunsa na decide say. Odi huhu na nyankopo di be ma nuno. Be ye be ye ye ma. Odi be ye ma boni. Edi huhu na nyankopo di ma obunsa no. Sa huhu mu e ye be ye. The same thing. Nyankopo su obo ye so no. That is why Jesus Christ said, it is of your benefit that I live. Because if I stay in this earth, me alone I can stay in you. And me alone I can stay in you. And me alone I can stay in you. And me alone I can stay in you. But if I leave, I am going to send the mediator, the Holy Ghost, that is paying you to do, that is paying you to die. And Saul, he will stay in you. He will stay in you. That is why on the day of Pentecost, when the Holy Ghost came, he stayed in them all. He was in them. He was working in them. And they took over. Was living in the environment of Haman, he never feared Haman. Because in those days, Mordecai had a revelation from the Holy Ghost that wherever I step my feet, that is where I will possess. Whenever I step my feet, wherever I go, I will possess that land. So physically, Haman thought Mordecai was living in the city. But Mordecai knows I possess the city. Even though there is a physical king, I am the king of the city. The Bible says, you don't know that you are the cause of this earth. So at that time, when he caught a revelation, he knows I am the god of the land. I own the land from India to Ethiopia. I own it. I own that place. All the land belongs to me. So I don't need to bow to anything that is in the land. Anything in the land needs to send me. I came to announce to you, you don't need to bow to any demon in your house. You don't need to bow to any spirit in your house. You don't need to bow to any demon in your house. Because they are your servant. When you possess them, possess them with power, possess them with strength. Take them by prayer. If there is a man to pray, but Mordecai discovered another revelation. Mordecai knows that my father was the one that created him. And my father was the one that created the father of him. That is the devil. So if my father was the one that created him, the Bible says, let me tell you something. Today, angels may have power than you. Let me tell you something. Angels may have power than you human beings, but you have authority than angels.
Yes.
They have power than you because you are created in the image and the likeness of God. You have the mind of God. You have the sense of God. You think like God. You do things for God. You are God on your own. You don't need anybody to push you to do something. The little push you have, you can do something. But angels, even though they are powerful, they are servants, they need to be saved before they do.
Yes.
That is why, as a human being, you can see, you can backslide, you can fall, but you can rise up and come back to your senses and move forward. But when an angel sees forever, that angel can never recover and come back. Because that authority has not been given to angels. They don't have it. You have it, but they don't have it. We went to this idea and then say, boy, you want it in my jam. And now, on to me, your she. Who soon to me, your she. So, see, wait till you see that, or lose where you soon. Then your blessing is balanced.